In this class, we are going to discuss about conversion of JK flip-flop to D flip-flop. So now we are going to discuss how to convert JK flip-flop to D flip-flop. As we are discussing flip-flop conversion from last classes, here you are going to do JK flip-flop to D flip-flop conversion. For any flip-flop conversion, you need truth table of destination flip-flop and excitation table of source flip-flop. So here destination flip-flop is nothing but here in this problem, here destination flip-flop is D, source flip-flop is JK. So in my sense, destination flip-flop is, so what to which flip-flop we want to convert, that is called as destination flip-flop, and the source flip-flop is from which we are going to convert, that I am considering like source flip-flop. So here to do this procedure of conversion, we require truth table of D flip-flop and excitation table of JK flip-flop. So here I take in both tables, truth table and excitation table of JK. So as a reference, I take in this. So you know how to design excitation table of JK and how you are getting truth table for D. All we discussed in the last classes in the topics of D flip-flop and excitation table of JK flip-flop, we discussed in that classes about clear explanation for these tables. So now as you know that D flip-flop is a transferent flip-flop, that means whatever we are giving in the place of D, same thing we are getting at output of that flip-flop. That means, so output of a flip-flop is nothing but next state. So whatever you are giving at D, so you don't know your present state, same thing you are getting at output. So that means without depending upon that present state, whatever you are giving with some delay, you are getting at output. So same thing you can see here, if 0, 1 are the D input, same 0, 1 will present at output. That means this is next state. I always telling you like this. So for any sequential circuit, your next state is your output. So here, coming to the excitation table, I already given you in the last class also about how to remember this excitation table of JK. You just consider present state and next state. So for any excitation table, if you observe, you will find your present state and next state first. After that, you are having input variables. So here present state and next state, the combination of present state and next state you need to consider, that means 00011011. So for better remembering, I am just giving you like a shortcut, but it's always better to go with a process which I already discussed in how to design an excitation table. But when we are in conversions, every time you are going to do that procedure and you are making excitation table, means that is somewhat typical. So that's why I'm giving some shortcut to remember this. That is, so after making this combination, so you just make JK here, and whatever Qn plus 1 is there, same thing you just write here except these two places. That means last two bits you just take, don't care. So the reverse of this will provide K. In case of SR flip-flop, you just maintain as it is as Qn plus 1 in place of S, and last, only last point you just make don't care, and the reverse of that will provide you R. Here in JK flip-flop, last two places you just consider at don't care. So whatever remaining bits are there, similar to Qn plus 1. Last two bits are don't care, reverse of this line, that means don't care 10, you can see this way. So that will gives you K. I am just giving this for better remembering, but it's always better to have a procedure to design excitation table that we already discussed in last class. So here to take conversion from JK flip-flop to D flip-flop, I am taking a conversion table. Always that conversion table, first of all we are taking truth table of destination flip-flop. So first we need to consider truth table of D flip-flop. After that, from the truth table we need to extend that as excitation table. That means, just see here, you will understand. So now I am just taking truth table of D. That truth table also I am taking extended truth table. Extended truth table means whenever I observe don't care, I am going to write 0 or 1. So, in case of D equal to 0, your Qn may be either 0 or 1. So, that means in D equal to 0 case, we will find when we extended this, we will get 2 cases. That means Qn may be 0 case, Qn may be 1 case. So, whatever Qn may be, your Qn plus 1 is equal to 0. So, this is D flip-flop. This output of D flip-flop always depends upon D. In any case, in any combination, it is not going to depend upon present state, only depend upon input variable. Whatever input we are having, we are getting it output, that is it. So, I am elaborating this case. So, when D is equal to 1, your Qn may be either 0 or 1. Now, so here also output is dependent upon only D, that is equivalent to D. So, here I am writing this case as like this. Okay, we taken the truth extended truth table of our destination flip-flop, that is here D flip-flop, and now from this truth table to excitation table I am going to extend. So, to extend this truth table to a excitation table of source flip-flop, so from which we need to consider means from here I am going to consider. So, see here, from here I am going to consider. So, I take in Qn, Qn plus 1, remaining what you need to take? J and K are remained to form as excitation table of JK. So, now I am just writing for this combination in this excitation table, what is the values for JK? So, I am just observing here and I am writing here. When Qn, Qn plus 1 is 0, 0, the JK values are 0, don't care. When Qn, Qn plus 1 is 1, 0, so 1, 0, your JK is don't care 1. So, when 0, 1 is there, you are having 1 don't care. And finally, when 1, 1 is there, you are having don't care 0. So, like this, you got your conversion table totally the overlapping of the truth table and destination table of source and destination flip-flops will gives you conversion table. By using this last two rows, by making K-map for these variables, source input variables, we are going to get the expression for conversion. So, next step is to take K-map. So, now how many variable K-map we need to consider? This is first step, that means making a conversion table. After that, we need to consider from which flip-flop to which flip-flop we are going to consider. From JK to D. That's why you need to consider the equation for J and K in terms of D. So, that's why I am taking equation for K. So, how many variable K-map you need to consider means again two variable K-map. I always telling you that don't consider this next state as input. Just in previous step, you take in the reference of your output. So, that's it. Always Qn plus 1 throughout the subject is output only. So, whatever present states are there, whatever input variables are there, those are said to be input for a sequential circuit. So, now only one input variable is there. We want to make this as input variable for our JK flip-flop. That's it. So, here this is present state. Present states also inputs of sequential circuits. So, now for this JK, whatever prior to this next state are there, those will be inputs. So, two variable K-map I am going to consider here. So, the possibilities are D and Qn. So, here I am writing the values 0 and 1 cell values. Now, this is the time to write number of ones in this K-map. Just I am writing for K-map for J I am considering here. So, now see here, you are having a don't care. Where you are having a don't care? At D equal to 0, Qn is equal to 1. At D equal to 0, Qn is equal to 1 means here you are having a don't care. And here you are having another 1. where you are having one means when d equal to 1 and qn equal to 0. So when d is equal to 1 and qn equal to 0 means here you are having 1, and here you are having another don't care. Another don't care you are having at 1-1 place. So like this you are having your don't care. Now this is the time for grouping. Is there any chance for double means? Yes, you are having a chance to group as a double with this don't care. And one don't care is remained. So you can leave the don't cares without grouping, because there is no need to group don't cares, as those are don't cares, no need to group. Don't cares are always used to group number of ones. No need to group don't cares, only you need to group ones. For that ones, if you want any don't cares in grouping, you can take. So here I am considering this prime implicant value to get the value of J. So sidewise there is no combination, even though this is covering two cells, there is no combination, only top value will take J is equal to D. So in the same way, I am taking K map for K. K map for K I am taking. So here also you need to consider two variable K map. So here I am considering D and Qn. So now, so here 0, 1 and 0, 1. So now where you are having your don't cares and ones means, here you are having don't cares when both 0 condition. And here you are having 1 when 0, 1 condition. 0, 1 condition means here D 0, Qn 1. And here you are having a don't care. That means D1, Qn0. D1 and Qn0 means here you are having another don't care. Now this is the time for grouping. Only one one is there. To group that one as a double, I am just using this don't care and I am leaving this don't care. So here whatever this single prime implicant value is there, that will become K value. Sidewise there is no combination, only top wise it's covering single cell. So that is also 0. That 0 represents D bar. So now here, after making K map for this source flip flop input variables, after getting expressions, now you need to design your flip flop. From which flip flop to which flip flop we need to consider means, from JK to D, that JK flip flop I am taking. So I am considering JK flip flop, so with clock pulse. So this is the symbol for JK flip flop, that's it. So Qn, Qn bar. So this is the symbol for JK flip flop. I take in JK flip flop. So to form this as D flip flop, you need to give D directly to J and through NOT gate to K. That means I am considering like this. I am giving directly to D and I am considering a NOT gate here and I am giving to K. So this is, so what you can observe here, the input of this flip flop is D and output is Qn, Qn bar. So that means, so whatever we are providing outputs, so it will take internally, you know the structure of JK flip flop, it will take the present input and present state and it will provide next state, that means Qn plus 1. So now previously you discussed the conversion structure from SR flip flop to D flip flop, that is also similar to this. That means, so here you are having SR flip flop, remaining is same. Why you are getting same structure for SR to D conversion and JK to D conversion means, where you are having difference between SR and JK means in last condition only. When you given 1-1 for JK, it's toggling, output is toggling. When you given 1-1 for SR, you are getting indeterminate condition. That is only the difference between SR flip flop and JK flip flop. So that condition we are not providing here. First of all, we are not providing that condition here. So that's why remaining is same means structure will also be same. Why we are not providing 1-1 condition means, if D equal to 0, automatically it will goes 1. If this is 1, it's coming as 0. So in any case, we are not getting 1-1 condition. So this is the conversion of JK flip-flop to D flip-flop.